Hello and welcome back. Today we are doing round two of dressing like iconic TV show characters. One of my favorite videos I've ever filmed on my channel was the video where I dress like iconic TV show characters, where I did Eleven from Stranger Things and Sabrina from Sabrina, The Chilling Adventures of Sabrina, Betty from Riverdale, and that was so fun. It was literally one of my favorite videos. As we all know, I'm a big fan of playing dress up. So today I have five new shows and five new iconic show characters. I've been waiting to do this for weeks now because I ordered everything, and because of the coronavirus, it has taken way longer to arrive to me. So today's the day that we commence this beautiful week of pretending to be people that we are not. Now, today I wanted to start off fairly simple. We are going to be doing Cassie from the show Euphoria. Of course, I had to do somebody from Euphoria. It's an amazing show. I'm sure a lot of you have seen it. If you haven't, ew. Originally, I was going to do Jules because she has the most fun and cute makeup and outfits, in my opinion. But as I was doing my research and trying to find outfits that would resemble hers, I found the exact dress that Cassie wore in the prom episode. And then I was like, that was one of my favorite looks of the entire show. Even though it was so simple, I just loved it. And we're doing Cassie. I already did my hair and makeup. I did very, very natural makeup because she doesn't look like she's wearing like any makeup, but I know she is wearing some face stuff. Her skin just looks really perfect and glowy, and that's the look I went for. And then her hair is curled. Here is the beautiful dress. Yes, it's the same exact one. I got it from House of CB. It was not cheap, but I just thought it was so pretty, and I'll probably wear it again sometime in the future. So makes sense, right? Anyways, I'm gonna put it on. 3, 2, 1. Oh my god, TikTok transitions, who? Already I think this is pretty accurate. To accompany this dress, she has like a little pink shawl. I ordered this from Amazon. It's like bubblegum pink. It didn't look like this in the photo. It will just have to do. Another thing I'm missing is Cassie's boobs, but I can't afford plastic surgery. No, I'm just kidding. And then the last thing is she has a little bejeweled bag. I don't know the right word, but she just wears that. And this is her prom look. What do you guys think? How accurate is it? I think it's pretty accurate. I'm going to be walking around my house dressed like I'm going to prom. Actually, this is way better than I looked when I went to my actual prom. My dress was $30.
But don't get me wrong, I still looked cute and I was on a budget.
You don't need money to look good. You just need
a great sense of style.
Anywho, let's go show somebody so I can get a reaction, so I can get some type of footage, because we're in quarantine and I can't really go anywhere unless I want to go to like a big empty field. Don't know why I would do that though.
Cute.
Nothing else?
I feel like you didn't put a lot of makeup on.
She's not wearing a lot of makeup. There's really not much I can do because I cannot go anywhere. I don't know where I would even go dressed like this. A high school prom. Wouldn't that be funny if I actually went to a high school prom? All right, I just filmed a TikTok, so I guess I'll show you that.
I fucking feel good.
Me too, bitch.
So if they got something to say, they should just say it to my face, right?
Or you could just say it to their fucking face.
Right?
That's what I would do. I feel like this is a turning point.
Totally.
I love this one. I feel pretty in it, and I think this dress is really cute. All right, guys. Well, I don't know what else to film in this outfit because there's just not much I can do. This one was very simple anyways, so the next ones will be a little bit more fun and exciting. I will see you tomorrow for Monday's look. Hello and welcome to day two. Clearly, I already have the makeup that is necessary for today's look on. I've just decided I'm not gonna be doing any makeup on camera because you've all seen me do my makeup on camera many, many times and we just don't need to see it again. Today is the look I am most excited for. It's honestly the reason I wanted to do this video again because it is one of my favorite TV show characters of all time. I'm not going to tell you who it is until I change, and then I wanna see if you can guess who it is. Some of you might already know by the makeup, but probably not, because I don't really look like her. Here I am with my rings and my necklace and my fake nose ring and
my outfit.
If you still don't know who I am, there is one more very important thing that we need to do, and it involves this bad boy. So I actually need to wet my hair for this. All right, this is gonna be more difficult than I thought. I'm just gonna do this off camera and come back to you because I have a feeling it's gonna take a really long time. If you do not know who I am right now, you probably have not seen the show. Today I'm dressing as Maeve Wiley from Sex Education. Maeve is literally one of my favorite characters in the history of characters. I love her. I think she's amazing. I remember one single line from season one, which, by the way, I am dressing as Maeve from season one because in season two she has brown hair. But I remember this one line where she's talking to Jackson at a party and he goes,
"What is your thing then?"
And she goes,
"Complex female characters."
And I will just never forget that line because same. My hair feels terrible right now. I use this hair chalk, which works really well because it looks pretty natural, but you have to like wet your hair and then drag it on. And my hair is like extremely frizzy, but I am not straightening it. Does this mean I have to talk in a British accent all day? Kidding. Also, does anyone ever notice how in the show she has a fake nose ring, but it's like huge? Like, this one looks real. Not to toot my own horn, but I feel like hers just looks so fake. Like, it's literally huge. I don't know why they did that.
Is that a British thing?
I'm kidding. British people, you know I love you. Don't attack me.
You look like Grease.
No, who do I look like?
Oh, what the hell's her name? I know who you are. I know who you are. You're that girl that...
What is that show?
We watched it together!
I know!
Sex Education.
Do you think I look like her?
Yes! Totally knew who you were.
Oh my god, I got Maeve in my car.
This is the first time I've left the house in probably 2 weeks. I have not been into an actual store in actually 2 months, I think.
Maeve shops online.
Yes, she does. Okay, well, I've been wearing this for a while now, and my hair feels really disgusting, and I really want to wash it, so I think I'm gonna end today here. This was really fun. I had fun dressing like Maeve. Like I said, she's one of my favorite characters ever, but I just want to change, because this isn't a very comfortable outfit. My hair literally feels so disgusting. I will see you guys tomorrow for day 3. It's gonna be a fun one. Hello, and welcome to day 3. As you can see, I'm already in the outfit. A little bit of a crazy day today because my brother is filming a video as well, so I just wanted to jump straight into it. If you don't already know who I am based off of my wig and outfit, you can't even see my skirt, but maybe this will help. Yes, today I am dressed as the iconic Blair Waldorf from Gossip Girl. Blair is another one of my favorite characters. I just think she's a queen. Always liked her more than Serena. I don't know. What do you guys think? Obviously, Blair has many, many iconic outfits. She's known for her style, but I felt like this one was the most generic one and recognizable one because it is the first picture that comes up when you look her up on Google, so I thought it was very fitting. I really like this one. I think it's cute and fun, and I'm wearing a skirt where my butt is literally hanging out of, but it's okay because that's what Blair had to go through. Fast forward a few hours. I've been in this outfit for a while. I had to film a video for Brandon and that took a while. And if I'm being honest, it is very hard to film a normal video because I can't really go anywhere. I just have been very, very demotivated lately. I can put this outfit on and show you, but I don't know what else to film with that because I'm literally not doing anything. I'm trying to be somewhat interesting and film interesting things, but bottom line is we're in quarantine and I can't do much. I'm sorry if this video is lacking a bit, but I still really enjoy dressing up and I think it's really fun and it's something fun for me to do like while I'm stuck inside. It just makes it a little bit harder to get footage of me in these outfits when like literally can't go anywhere or do anything. My brain is just all over the place and I don't know. I don't feel 100% like myself, so isn't that funny because I'm dressed as someone else? We're just gonna keep going. We're gonna keep trying and hopefully you like it. Welcome to the most riveting part of my day, where I mash up cat food for Salem so that she can eat her probiotics. Yum. Salem is so excited. She loves this stuff.
Here's the probiotics that I give her. They have helped her so much. I mentioned in a video that she had lost a lot of weight and she was really skinny. And after like 2 weeks of eating this, she is like back to her normal weight. Thank you, probiotics.
Are you ready?
There she goes. That looks
so fucking repulsive. Oh my god. This is the footage that you're getting. Also, I took the wig off because it was itchy. I just realized I took my wig off before I got a Blair Waldorf montage. I don't care. I'm PMSing. I'm sad. I'm angry.
I'm extremely irritated.
What do I do when I'm irritated? I eat bread. Chewy bread. I really do look like a schoolgirl now. I kind of like it. I've been watching a lot of movies. I watched the entire Harry Potter series the other week because I hadn't seen it since I was like really young. I just love anything with magic or witches or fantasy. I seriously have not had a romantic interaction with another human in probably 5 months at least. That's not even talking about quarantine. That's just my life.
There I go again. Being relatable.
I'm losing my mind. Anyone else just losing their fucking mind? I don't know where I am right now. I need to go for a walk. Okay, guys, that is all for day 3. I will see you tomorrow for the second to last day. Here's the deal. I was so excited for this one. Obviously, I'm dressed as Quinn Fabray from Glee. Suddenly, the world I used to know, I see it differently. You woke me from a dream, now here's reality. Baby, baby, you are really hurting me. I was very excited for this one. I loved Glee in middle school. It is the only thing I have ever made a fan account for. I was obsessed with it. Now looking back on it, it's a very questionable show, but if you grew up with it, you just understand it's just a part of you. And I always wanted to be Quinn. I thought she was so beautiful and so cool, even though she was like kind of terrible sometimes. And I loved the little Cheerios uniforms. I wanted to be a Cheerio so bad. So I was very excited to make my middle school dreams finally come true. And I found this really authentic looking Cheerio uniform on Amazon. I was so freaking excited to get it and try it on. And then it came to me and I realized that it was a child size small. So in order to get it on my body, I had to cut open the entire back. So it's like somebody printed this onto my body. Not gonna lie, I'm really upset about this. I like used string to tie it together. It's taped on the side because I don't want to sew it to this shirt. Very upset. I didn't even do my hair or makeup for this one because A, I got my period this morning. B, it is raining and dark outside, which both of those things combined means I have absolutely no motivation to do anything today. But we can't stop and we won't stop. But I couldn't order another one, even like a shittier version of it, because everything takes so long to ship on Amazon right now. I was just so excited for it and I was excited to do my ponytail and curl it, but my hair is super freaking frizzy and disgusting today. It doesn't look that bad on camera. From far away. Anyways, in spirit of me being dressed as Quinn Fabray, I prepared a little something for you. Okay. A moment I wake up before I put on my makeup. I say a little prayer for you. While combing my hair now, I wonder what dress you wear. Yeah, it took me like 2 hours to learn that. Sorry. Once again, today is a struggle, but all that matters is that we're here with a fake cheerleading uniform taped on our bodies. Sorry, I'm really not putting in any effort today, but there's too much going on right now. Not gonna talk about all my personal problems because no one wants to hear that. Anyways, I don't even know what to fucking film. It's like, oh, from the back? Yeah, I'm just a normal girl. Psych, I'm a Cheerio. Business in the back, party in the front.
Does the girl not do makeup?
No, she doesn't. I can't.
There's a reason behind all this madness. I hear your tape crackling.
Hello and welcome to the last day, day five. I'm so happy that this is the last day. If you don't know who I am, there's a good chance you haven't seen this show. Today I am dressed as Effie from the show Skins. I feel like this is pretty accurate when I'm looking at myself in the viewfinder. I feel like I look like her. I only watched the first season of Skins, but I know for a fact it was a very iconic, popular show. It ended a while ago, so a lot of you might not know what it is, but it's basically just a British show about sex and drugs and teenagers in high school. Effie is, in my opinion, the most iconic character in the show, and when I had dark hair, literally everyone told me I looked like her. I actually turned myself into her for my first turning myself into my celebrity lookalikes video, but all I really did was put black eyeshadow on and I didn't really look anything like her. So today I thought I'd give you the full Effie makeover. No, I did not dye my hair brown. I used this hairspray from L'Oreal that worked so well. I'm shocked. Today I'm going to my dad's house to film a video for Brandon. So I'm going to get my dad's reaction and tell him I dyed my hair brown. Like, I don't feel like I look exactly like her because we have completely different noses. Hers is more like small and upturned, but this is the only time I've ever seen a resemblance between us.
I like it. I think you should stay that way.
You say that about literally everything I dress up as.
Hey.
Look at me.
You look like one of those weirdos in high school.
Do you see my hair?
Yeah, it's light brown. That looks good. What do you want me to do? Stand on my head? It looks good.
My life. I'm breaking the fourth wall. Behind the scenes. Dude, it really looks like I have brown hair. This is weird. I'm not dyeing my hair brown. It's 2011. I'm back home now. My little angel. She wants a T-R-E-A-T. I don't really know what else to film today. So I would just, again, like to apologize for yesterday. Everyone has their off days, okay? I kind of like the brown hair, but also probably will not dye my hair brown anytime soon. I really hope you guys enjoyed this video. Through my ups and my downs, my highs and my lows, we made it out in the end. I'm gonna go wash my hair.
You want to say hi again?
Yeah, she's a little attention whore, but can you blame her? Look at her mom. Oh, I'll see you guys in my next video. Thank you so, so much for watching. Bye. We're gonna see what is underneath this braid. Do you see the pink still in there? I don't know if you can see it on camera, but truly look. That's terrible. Ugh.